Okay, so you've heard from Rajiv Chandrasekhar suggesting that there will be new energies. These are the new soldiers, he says, of Modi 2.1. Now, how are these soldiers going to meet the challenges? What are the challenges in a way? Can Team Modi really fix the economy and COVID management, which many believe, as Mr. Chandrasekhar also said, are important priorities? Can the government restore its image hurt by the COVID mess? Has the cabinet reshuffle inspired confidence a day later? I'm joined by someone who perhaps has an inside track because he's worked very closely with governments. Dr. Sanjay Baru, media advisor in the Manmohan Singh government, now, of course, independent policy and political analyst. Appreciate your joining us, Dr. Baru. I want your first reactions to, in a way, this cabinet reshuffle being called a big bang, a makeover. Did you see it as that, or is it more about optics and less about substance because the key ministers in and around the Prime Minister have only been juggled around? Do you see it as a major makeover?
Well, it's not a major makeover. It's certainly an important turning point for the Modi government, which has been in deep trouble for the last 1 year, not just because of the COVID, but the fact that the economy continues to stagnate. There are serious concerns about economic growth. There are serious concerns about coming out of the impact of the lockdown. There are serious concerns about the unemployment rising, poverty rising, uncertainty about the future. We have seen the consequences of all that in the recent assembly elections. The Prime Minister's own popularity rating has come down. So this cabinet reshuffle, I imagine, was aimed at addressing a lot of challenges that the government is facing. You're right, the economic policy team has not been touched. We don't have any change in the ministries of finance or commerce or industry or even Niti Aayog, or indeed in the Prime Minister's office. So the core economic policy team remains in place. Now, therefore, I don't expect any major change in what the Prime Minister is likely to do as far as the economy is concerned, which in my judgment is the biggest challenge. But I think the interesting thing about this reshuffle is the political dimension to it. I see the very fact that BJP spokespersons yesterday briefed the media about the caste composition of the new ministry is astounding. You know, this has never been done before. And that too by a party that has in the past rejected caste divisions within the Hindu community, that has tried to unite the Hindus as one group and said that all this caste politics is not in the interest of Hinduism or of the country. For that kind of a political party to actually brief the media.
But the new media is like, OBCs. But isn't that, Dr. Baru, the new BJP being like the old Congress? You know, the political fix that we have to get, we have to ensure that every caste is represented. Is that the real, that's not going to fix the governance challenge. Let's be clear.
No, it's not going to
in terms of priorities, surely the governance challenge, the economy, as you mentioned, is far more important at the moment than ensuring winning elections in Uttar Pradesh to political representation. Because again, there is no evidence to say that having a member from, let's say, the Yadav caste will win you votes of the Yadavs in Uttar Pradesh. That's a very old way of looking at politics, isn't it?
Yes, it is. And I'm not suggesting that it is the votes that are being targeted. But it is within the party, these elements which are being targeted. In other words, the feeling that we have not received adequate representation within the corridors of power, that the party continues to be dominated by a certain political elite within the BJP. I think there is a change. There is certainly a change in this BJP. I mean, we have traveled a long distance from 2014, in which the Minister of Finance, the Minister of Defense, Minister for Road Transportation, etc. I mean, Arun Jaitley, Sushma Swaraj, Nitin Gadkari, Prakash Jha, all Brahmins. And today we are being told that 27 OBCs are there. So there is a politics.
So this is a shift in the
transition.
Power elite. In a way, a shift that you are seeing in the power elite or the nature of government now in terms
within
of
the BJP.
Within the BJP. Interesting point that you are making there. However, do you believe that this nature of this government is in place to meet the challenges that lie ahead? Do you believe, what would you have done differently? If you were advising Prime Minister Modi, I know you're not, but if you were, what would you tell him?
Well, look, first of all, I'm no longer in the business of advising anybody, but forget about meeting the challenges of the future. The real challenge for us are the challenges of the present. poverty has gone up, unemployment has gone up, economic investment is not picking up, you know, schools are not functioning, colleges are not functioning, young people are worried about the future. There are serious challenges. And I think unless the government shows that its reconstitution is aimed at addressing these challenges, and that actually in the next few months we see a more performing government, then it will only be about caste and, you know, accommodating various pressure groups, various interest groups across different states. You're going for elections in UP or Gujarat, or there's unhappiness in Karnataka. Mm-hmm. You know, people want the chief minister removed, or there's unhappiness in Bengal because they didn't make it there. So you have more people from Bengal in the cabinet, more people from Karnataka. You know, these are all political challenges that the Modi government is facing, or the BJP is facing. Mm-hmm. So I don't see the reconstitution of the ministry as really focused on governance or on the real economic challenges we are facing. These are serious challenges. And then there are a lot of security challenges. I mean, China is still a major problem, and I really no idea how we are going to be addressing that challenge. It's going to only become a bigger challenge. Now, Afghanistan, the Americans are leaving. There's a major security challenge on our borders. So I'm not convinced that this reconstitution addresses all those challenges.
Let me ask you one final question, and I also put, and Mr. Chandrasekhar raised it, that I asked him whether this was a PMO-centric government and therefore the ministers really were just showpieces, had no real powers. And he contrasted it with the UPA, saying now at least we have a leadership which is accountable, according to him, as contrast to the UPA where the Prime Minister himself had no control over his ministers. You were part of that UPA as media advisors to Dr. Singh. Is that a big difference? Should we be looking for a PMO-centric government, or should we be looking at the Manmohan Singh model?
We are a parliamentary system in which the government is led by the Prime Minister, who is only primus inter pares. Mm-hmm. The Council of Ministers, Cabinet Ministers are important. There are Cabinet Committees. Apart from the Cabinet Committee on Security, I'm not sure if the Cabinet Committee on Political Affairs has ever met, or the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has ever met. We never hear of these Cabinet Committees meeting. Mm-hmm. Maybe they're not being reported. Maybe they're meeting secretly. One doesn't know. This is a cabinet form of government. And you cannot convert a cabinet form of government into a presidential system by having retired bureaucrats as ministers. There are political, you know, constituencies that require representation. So from that point of view, this reshuffle to me suggests that it is addressing the need to represent political constituencies in the government.
Right.
And that is why the briefing given to the media, there are so many OBCs, so many SCs, so many STs, so many women. I mean, this social composition, to me, is the most interesting aspect of this reshuffle.
I, you know, you've been very wise in telling us about why you need in a parliamentary democracy a cabinet system that works in a way through ministers being given autonomy, as opposed to a top-down approach. Only one person can't call the shots. You don't need a political fix as much as a governance fix also at the moment. But Dr. Baru, as always, thanks very much for sharing your wisdom on the cabinet and what you saw as crucial in this reshuffle. Okay, speaking about